What advice do you have for introverts? One, how do we deal with the idea that character is good or bad in itself, that right or wrong is only in one's perception?
Okay, for introverts, you need to build your self-esteem. You need to leave your comfort zone so that you can do your networking skills very, very well. So, I was an introvert as I was growing up. I had to start talking and talking. People will tell you talk too much. But what you really need is to build your self-esteem. Because really, why do people want to keep quiet when others are talking? What is really introvert? Your lips are not moving, but in your mind, you are mentally busy. And for networking skills, you need to learn to speak up. So our advice, you read around communication, then read books that will build your self-confidence. Look, your circle of influence, the people in your life, the people who will influence your decisions, you need to also check that. If there are people who don't believe in you, if there are people who don't trust what you do, you will never leave your comfort zone. So you need to identify people in your cycles who can influence you positively, who believes in you, who can make you leave that your comfort zone so that you cannot have a new skill to now network.
The Honorable Commissioner, how does one get the legal guidelines in starting a hospital or medical practice business?
We are trying to set up a one-stop shop where all the information for business and incentives are guaranteed. But beyond that, the Ministry of Wealth Creation can help you gather all the information you need to start a business in Edo State. Location, soil tests, soil size, land use, location of land, availability of funds, what incentives government can give are available in the Ministry of Wealth Creation. Let me just quickly say this. Edo is the best state to invest. I'm not saying it to make you feel good. Edo State in another few years will be second to none because Edo State is the center of Nigeria. Edo State is the center of transportation. You can't pass to any part of Nigeria without passing through Edo State, whether by air, by road, or by sea. So this is the best state. Anything you want to do about starting a business, just come to Ministry of Wealth Creation. We will advise you, tell you where to go, how to go, and how to get funds. Let me just say this. We want to pull together all artisans in Edo State. I want to create a platform where they can network. We want to teach them how to use their phone to get business and be rich and change their business attitude and mentality so that they don't need to look dirty to make money, whether you are a mechanic, you are a vulcanizer, you are a carpenter, you are a shoemaker, or that. That will be happening in November. And we are going to create an app where they can sell themselves, that you need to just contact a mechanic. You can create that app and contact the mechanic. We are doing that one in November, so we have this opportunity to plan. I'm letting the cat out of the bag.
How long will this business clinic last? And then, I want the state government to give me land to farm. What do I do?
This was put together in such a short time, and we did not expect this outcome we have. So first of all, I have to say we are actually happy. We've decided within ourselves it has to continue. So we're planning to have this biannually, twice a year.
When starting a business, how necessary is it to carry out physical analysis or research?
I think the basic thing is, if you have an idea and your idea is built around a business that when people use it without much effort from you, they want to tell their neighbors. If you have such an idea or you have a business around such, a solution around such, you are almost good to go. You don't have to spend time to perfect it. When you have something people can at least use, yes, you might have taken your time to do your research and you have your milestones on things and things to bring in. So that is it. There are no specifics. As far as you get something going that the people can use, push it to the market. Sometimes the feedback from the people will tell you what to do and how to add some services to it. Just as Mandela said, we push this out. The feedback we are getting now is telling us that we need to do this twice a year. The feedback is telling us that we need to do this for artisan. You can see. So that's how it is. When you throw out what you have, the feedback will give you a lot of information on how to begin to take the other steps. Then as regards the necessary research and everything you need to do about business, like I tell people, business is not what you think. Business is what is. What is the reality on the market. The reality on the market requires that you do your research. First, what problem are you trying to solve? Secondly, who are those currently solving the problem? How are they solving it? What difference am I bringing on board? When you have been able to answer all of that, who are my competitors? What are they doing? What am I going to do to be able, because right now, any idea you have, to be frank, somebody is already doing it.
Sir, what is the difference between cash inflow and net profit, and how does it affect how I'm being taxed?
Cash inflow is all the revenue. Even outside revenue, everything that comes in by way of cash into the business is cash inflow. But net profit is the difference between revenue and expenditure. That is your net profit. If you subtract all your expenditure from your revenue, assuming you are a trading concern, that is sales less expenses gives you profit. And it is that profit that is subjected to tax, because we are looking at income tax. Net profit is the same thing as income. It's the same thing as gain. It is the same thing as surplus. It depends on how you are looking at it.